County Pinsett. Rustic Butterflies. Rustic Butterflies, County Pinsett.
How many of you, by a show of hands, were immersed in March Madness last month? As was I, although mine was of a slightly different variety. March Monarch Madness, as in the butterflies. Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and honored guests, last month I set out to find a plant that attracted butterflies. I find the way that butterflies evolve from a caterpillar to a pupa to a dazzling display of color simply amazing, truly a sublime portrayal of the human journey. Plus, I had a gift card to the garden store. Do you know how expensive the garden store is? It seemed that all I could get with my gift card would be decorative trinkets. I was determined not to be sidetracked by the adorable garden gnomes and the very cute pottery paw frogs. So I was really excited when I saw the decorative glass butterflies, and they were casting shimmering shades across the nearby foliage. But inexplicably, I kept being drawn back to this metal, sturdy garden stake shaped like a butterfly. Rusty, kind of beautiful too. Also, being in the discount bin, I could afford it. Upon returning home from my somewhat successful mission, I picked up the local periodical and I eagerly anticipated reading this weekly paper. It is a gossipy gazette, and I could not wait. I tore it open and I looked at my favorite column, the police blotter. Yeah. It's an entertaining diversion that reminds us all we ain't so far away from white trash. But then I saw it. An obituary. This paper does not post many obituaries. Its homey, Mayberry-esque tone lends itself better to high school basketball or city council meetings. And this one was even different. I knew this lady. Well, kind of knew her. Her kids had gone to school way back then together. All right, I didn't really know her very well. I just stalked her so much that I felt as if I knew her well. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever met someone in your life whose qualities you admired, possibly because you felt you were lacking in those qualities? Maybe made up stories about them that had maybe no basis in truth. This girl, she was perfect. She had perfect hair, the perfect smile. She never said a cross word to anyone. And she never yelled at her kids. No minivan for her. She had a beautiful white car, new, with white leather interior, with kids. She lived on the fancy side of town. She was so sweet. Every time she drove by, she would wave to me. Even though we hadn't personally interacted in almost a decade. Damn it. Her cellulite free butt looked amazing in yoga pants. She was my hero. She was my age. People my age don't die. Who was I going to be when I grew up? And as I sat there pondering the random unfairness of it all, I raised two amazing children. They are kind, productive members of society. For 2 decades, I've been a contributing partner to a successful marriage. I own my own business. Some people say I'm a role model. And although I believe firmly that my life is a constant metamorphosis, I'm no longer a butterfly, a caterpillar looking to become a delicate, beautiful butterfly. I am a butterfly. We all are butterflies, each in different stages, each doing work within our silk cocoon, and eventually emerging in our unfurling glory. Some of us are delicate and beautiful, rare species of butterflies. Many of us are the more common monarch butterflies, beautiful, with a rustic patina and sophistication, long on own. Excuse me, I'm gonna go try on some yoga pants. Mr. Toastmaster.